So the boat's just getting set here. We're going to see Germany, Poland, Australia, Estonia, Ukraine, and GB in this final. Germany, the Olympic champions from 2012. Three of this crew won the gold. Hans Gruner is the newcomer. He replaced Tim Grohmann. And Poland, they were Olympic champions 8 years ago in Beijing, but were last in the final in London 4 years ago. Bronze medalists at Eton Dorney, Australia. Bronze also in Atlanta, silver in 84 is the best they've managed. Estonia, the same crew that were agonizingly just outside the medals in London. Jamseraja, Hendrickson and Timesu. The Ukraine, bronze medalists in Athens. World best time holders. Three of this crew were 11th in London. And GB, who've never medaled in this boat, have an entirely different crew from the one that came last in both 2004 and then fifth in the Olympic final at home in London. So we are good to go here for the final of the men's quad sculls, the first gold medal race of Rio 2016. They're on their marks. Red to green, and we are underway then in this A final in the men's quad sculls. Germany, Poland, Australia, Estonia, Ukraine, and GB. This promises to be such a tight one. The Germans are the Olympic champions, but by no means overwhelming favourites to take the gold again.
No, I think that title probably belongs to the Australians. Carsten Forsterling there in the bow, bronze medalist in London. We're in for a very tight race here. The Germans, they've got such pedigree, and not seeing them in shot, I think, suggests to me they've got to jump on the field, and looks like they have. And over in lane five, Ukraine off to a good start.
World best time holders, the Ukraine indeed, with five on their bow. GB in six, trying to move up now and respond. It is Germany. Tim Grohmann was in the boat with Schulze and Wender. So three of those men know what it's like to win an Olympic gold medal. They did it at Eton Dorney, were roared on by that famous Dorney roar in London 4 years ago. And it's really quite close between Germany and the Ukraine, and Australia not having it all their own way. Bronze 4 years ago, Forsterling and McRae were in that boat. In have come Cam Girdlestone and Alex Belonogov, and it's going to be very, very tight at the 500. It's Germany, and four of them close for that second place. Ukraine and GB in third at present.
Yeah, all within half a second there. Look at those bows lined up across the course. This is going to be some fantastic racing. Good start there from Germany. Defending, well, reigning Olympic champions. That's how you can't defend a title. You've got to go back out and win it. And first last year, they haven't had a great run of form at the start of the season, but they brought back in Hans Grunier into the stroke seat, and it's definitely making a difference. Australia, well, they've got to hold their composure now. I think the Australians probably thought they'd have the measure of Germany. Two seat there, Alexander Belonovkov, just looking over, seeing where they are. Viest into second, and Ukraine slipped back from that second position, but still very tight across the field.
GB well in contention near side. First ever world championship medal in this boat. Only came as recently as 2013. So despite all their pedigree in rowing down the years, GB have never done it when it mattered really in the men's quad sculls, but they are well in the hunt for medals here. But it is still Germany striding out to getting on for a boat length's lead here over Australia. Great performance when it comes down to the crunch here from Germany. Gruner in the stroke seat, shoots and Schulzer in the two and three, and then Vender in the bow. And at the midway point, it is Germany by some distance from Australia and then Estonia.
Yeah, good response back there from Estonia. Push back through Great Britain. Great Britain have Jack Beaumont in the bow, who is coming for Graham Thomas, who unfortunately got a virus on the plane over and has done a sterling job at getting them into this, or helping them get into this A final here. Didn't have a great heat, but responded well to just finish behind Germany in the repercharge. And this is a big turn up, really, in the fact that Germany, from the outside lane, having not won their heat, finishing third behind Estonia and Ukraine, and won the repercharge, but now find themselves leading the Olympic final.
Well, a German crew, east or west, has won gold at 6 of the 10 games since the men's quad skulls was first introduced to the Olympic program back in Montreal in 1976. And they are out in front in this 2016 final. It is Germany from the Aussies and Estonia going well. Dropping off the pace are the Ukrainians, but GB still in the hunt. But it's Australia leading the field behind Germany, who are still rowing so, so strongly in lane one. They have saved themselves for this final. Through come the Aussies. It is Estonia in four. They've missed out on multiple occasions, the Estonians, but a solid crew with Taimsu stroking and then Raya and Hendrickson and Yamsa in the bow. It's the same crew that were fourth in London into the last 15, and it's Australia now trying to build this surge on Germany.
So probably less than a minute 30 to go, and again we see Great Britain crew starting to go a bit sideways on the course. Australia, they've got to try and move now if they're going to go. They're in that silver medal. The Olympic title has never been out of Europe. Can they be the ones to push past Germany and to take Olympic gold? At this stage, the Germans, see there, big yell from the bow, Philip Wendy. He knows they've got a chance here, a great chance here to win the Olympic title. And they're lifting their rating now.
It's Germany from Australia and Estonia being pushed all the way by Poland. Australia surging for the line, 17.50. And have Australia, the in-form crew in 2016, got what it takes at the end here to take that Olympic gold medal away from the Europeans. It's Australia gaining every stroke on Germany, and Estonia looking good for the bronze.
Yeah, great race here from Germany. They're really digging deep. I think they're paying for that effort they put in the start. Looking a little ragged there in the three seat. The oars starting to go up in the air. Australia looking very tidy still, pushing through. But are they going to run out of racetrack? It's going to come down to the wire. 100 metres to go now. Germany versus Australia. Germany, half a length to the line.
And Germany take the gold medal again. Australia, the form crew in 2016, have the Olympic silver and a bronze medal for Estonia. They're on the podium, but it is Germany who win the gold again. What is it about the formula that they find in the men's quad skulls? It's another gold for Schulze, Vender and Schoof, and Hans Gruner as well, but will be crowned Olympic champion. 6.06.81. Germany win the gold again.
What an amazing race there. I don't think Australia were expecting that. Silver medalists, you know, you can see from their faces what they were here for. They were here for gold. And fantastic racing, very level across the rest of the field. Estonia wrapped with that bronze medal, but no doubting the victors. They put it out there from lane one.
Leading from the front the whole way there. They had faith in their ability. And a fantastic gold medal again for this German quad. Brilliant run of success. And just what is it about this boat and the Germans?
It takes a lot of knowledge, I think, from their coaches, Coach Alex Schmidt, to put together a performance. Crew changes through the year. Haven't won a race this season. And here they are, Olympic champions, led from the start to Germany. Great form, nice flat drive. I think the Australians maybe a little bit rattled by the fact they weren't out in front. They've had good leads in some of their other races. And had a fight back at the end there. They were a length down, came back to half a length. Germany started to look a little ragged, but they played their cards to perfection. And Olympic champions again are Germany. You can see what it means there to Hans Grunje.
Well, they just shuffled it around a bit with Grunje coming into this boat in that last World Cup regatta of the season. It had an immediate effect with the Germans winning a silver behind the Aussies, who won those last two World Cup races, didn't they? In Poznan and Lucerne behind that. But Germany, as you mentioned there, win an elite race for the first time since the World Champs last year. But they found what's needed in the A final in the Olympic Games. And Germany are crowned champions again in the men's quad sculls. Australia with a silver, Estonia with the bronze.
Yeah, well, we had a lot of talk about how the conditions were going to affect the finals here, but Lagoa Rodriguez de Freitas has put on a great platform for Germany to become the Olympic champions.
So we're going to see the victory ceremony for the men's quadruple sculls. A great performance from Germany. They were always so strong in this event. And all smiles, the Aussies too. There was every suggestion that they might win a gold here. But Germany know how to do it. 2012 Olympic champions, and they followed it up with a gold medal in the Worlds last year and Olympic triumph again. And terrific, actually, for the Estonians also.
Yeah, very experienced crew, the Estonians. 10 Olympic appearances between them. The bow, Andre Jamsi, was a silver medalist in the double in Beijing. An average age of 33. I think they'll be pleased with that result. Les médailles seront remises par Monsieur James Tompkins, Australie. Membre du Comité international olympique, olympien. Trois médailles d'or. James Tompkins, accompagné de Monsieur Patrick Rombaud, Belgique. IOC Athletes Commission member, member of the awesome foursome. The medals will be presented by Mr. James Tompkins, Australia, member of the International Olympic Committee, Olympian, three gold medals and one bronze medal. Accompanied by Mr.
Was an early partner of Drew Chin, I think, wasn't he, in the double?
In the pair,
in the pair rather.
As medalhas serão entregues pelo Sr. James Tompkins, Austrália, membro do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, campeão olímpico, três medalhas de ouro.
Yeah, fantastic actually for Estonia. It's the same four that were fourth in London. The oldest crew in the event, average age of 33. Médaillé de bronze. Eight finalists at the last three Worlds. And all that nous. Tonu Hendrickson, racing on the senior circuit since 2000. Four world medals to his credit. And teammates almost as experienced as he is. Jamsir and Raya have made their senior debuts way back in 03 and 04. And Timesu at 29 is the baby of the crew. He was ninth in Beijing, Timesu, and then part of that crew that were fourth, this crew, this same group that were fourth at Eton Dorney. European champions though, so did have form coming into this competition that weren't there in Poznan, outside the medals back in Varese.
Yeah, they had a fantastic heat and won that pretty comfortably.
Medaille d'argent. Silver medalists. Medaille de prata. Australie. Australia. Australia.
I think now starting to sink in the fact that they are an Olympic medalist. A disappointment of missing the gold. Now being replaced by the thrill of winning an Olympic silver. Carsten Forsling there. Second medal.
Cameron Gervelstone. James McRae.
James also in that quad from London.
Yeah, the newbies, Cam Girdlestone and Alex Sasha Belonogov, 28 and 26 respectively, also raced in the double sculls and had some success in that boat class as well.
Belonogov also pushed out David Crawshay, Olympic gold medalist in the double.
So
definitely some talent there. Everyone for the next time, but no doubting Olympic champions.
Yeah, this German quad have done it again. Old hands at this now, Schuf, Schulze and Wender. But Hans Gruner, whose stroke this particular German gold medal winning boat was there in 2008 before Tim Grohmann stepped into the boat. Silver in Poznan behind the Aussies, but when it came to the big day at the Olympics, it was the Germans.
So traditionally, the medalists get together for a photo on the podium, share their moment of glory.